Welcome, folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the Wichita State Shockers and the Dayton Flyers. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Well, basketball fans, we have a great matchup for you to keep your eyes on at the small forward position.
And the referee is ready to toss it up.
Play ball, baby. Play ball as Ebert tosses it up.
And we're underway.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shows the sweet touch. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well, as well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. In the lane, and come up short. Davis receives the ball. Perimeter. Tries for two. Drains the shot. Good cut. Great pass right there.
When the defense plays too aggressive, those types of passes are going to be open. There it is. Jam City.
There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Trying to feed the low block. He rejects it. Fed the low block. Number 24 picks up the foul. First personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Inside, puts up the jumper, off the mark. Smith receives the ball. Dumps it in. Goes up for two. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
Hey, Brad, he's got a really good all-around game. Can step out to about 15 feet and knock it down and score with his back toward the basket.
Scores it. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 33. He gets the foul and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys in your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
Trying to feed inside.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man.
Either. Good job defensively. For two. Comes up short. Smith handles the feed. Gave it up. He attempts the jump shot. Missed the jumper. Working it around the perimeter for the bucket. Knocks it down. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
When the defense plays too aggressive, those types of passes are going to be open.
On the left side. He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Trap.
Well done. Great trap.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, that's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and you spin back the other way.
Defense is right up on him, not giving any open looks.
He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't get it to him. Knocks it down. The Flyers did a great job there of penetrating and then kicking the ball outside.
Hey, the ball handler drew the defense in and then found a teammate on the perimeter who was spotting up.
Here's a double team. On the dribble, gives it up, tries for two. It's good. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Goes up for two. That's good. Gave it up. Goes up with a shot. Can't connect.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Now trying to feed the low block. For two. In and out. Point guard receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. And it's dripped. Active hands. Inside for the bucket. Jumper won't go. Moving it around the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Nails the J. The shooting guard receives the ball. He shoots the jumper. Knocked it down. Williams receives the ball.
Great anticipation defensively.
On the dribble, gives it up. For three. Missed it. Pushes it up. Tries for two. He nails the bucket. Definitely a foul. The layup counts and the foul.
He went hard to the hoop knowing he was going to get fouled.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
Free throw is good. Oh, this man's in trouble. The Flyers seemingly have a solid number of seniors in their lineup, Dick.
Hey, Brad, you know I love seniors. By the time they're in their fourth year of eligibility, they're solid and reliable basketball players.
Nails a sweet jumper. They work the perimeter. From way outside. Nope. He grabs the board. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. And a momentary look from three-point land.
Silly mistake.
Goes up for two. Nope. For two, he hits the shot. For the bucket. Buried it. The Shockers are considered pretty balanced, I think, when talking about their style of play, wouldn't you say, Dick?
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court.
And the strip, quick hand.
Double team now, bad angle.
Tries for two, scorches the net.
Try to go inside.
The turn, a fadeaway jumper. Off the mark. Gave it up. Commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first. Problems so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in a full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Neslow. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
goes up for two. It won't fall. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Now they work it around the perimeter. They've got a player spotting up on the three. He knocks down the jumper. They'll work it around the arc. He looks at the hoop. Puts up the J. And come up short.
Look at that spacing.
Three. About 5 minutes remaining. Bust the jumper. They look to get it to the inside. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
That's the luxury of the home court advantage. You have the crowd chanting, jumping around, fired up. It is awesome.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Cross court. He puts up the J. Knocks it down. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. For two. He nails the shot. The outside. He bombs from outside. The missed shot. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Jumper won't go. Robinson receives the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The center takes the feed.
Dump it inside.
He pulls up with a jumper. Can't connect.
Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Jumper nails the jumper. Number 12 receives the ball, takes his jumper, nails the J. Gave it up. Now the turnaround jumper. Nope.
High post screen, gonna use it.
Looking for a good shot. Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper. Down inside. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Toronto fadeaway. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
We're at the 1 minute mark. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important, to 15 to 17 feet apart.
He shoots from outside. Scores it. On the outside. From the corner. Missed it. For the bucket. Nice shot. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper with a final shot. That was nice. At the half, the Shockers are trailing by two. Dayton was on fire in that first half shooting from the field, partner.
I'll tell you, fire's not the word, man. They were blistering, just burning it up. We'll see if they can keep it up in the second half.
Number 32 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Looks like a full-court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Oh, yes. For two, goes.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Puts it on the floor and up and under. Off the mark. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Flyers have done a great job at the offensive end. Specifically, they were able to push the ball in transition and exploit the opposition's inability to get back on defense. Dick, you mentioned this earlier as an important point, and sure enough, it's made a difference. Let's see if they can keep it up in the second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Inbounds play on the baseline. Hard foul. He gets the layup to go and the foul.
What a hoop. He saw the defender coming and tried to go right through him.
He'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He tries the jumper. They get it to go. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how to dribble use the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Trying to pack it inside.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude Dunkaroo.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots the jumper.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Scorches the net with a J. Gave it up. He puts up the J. The missed shot. The point guard takes the pass. They go into the low block with the jumper. Bust the J. Check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They're working around the perimeter. The turn, the fadeaway jumper.
You talk about versatility. Aren't many guys that are going to make that fadeaway jump shot. Great touch. Impossible to block that shot.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Flyers' last time out was an intense one. Their coach was all over them for the lack of effort during that last stretch. He sees them starting to fade and being less aggressive. Two things that will definitely hurt them in a game like this.
Well, that was certainly a lot to take in on the sidelines.
Hey, that's a coach who knows what he wants from his team. He understands what they are capable of, and he doesn't want to see them slip and play below their level.
Jumper won't go. Trying to feed the low block. He pulls up with a jumper. Off the mark. Let's it fly. Can't get the shot to drop. He hits it. Come with a double team to stop it. Goes up with it.
And the bricks just keep on coming, baby.
I have to start looking for some easier baskets here, Dick. Working it around the perimeter. He attempts the three. Nope. He takes the board. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Looking for a good shot. He attempts a jump shot. Knocks it down. moving it around the perimeter. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Too physical. The layup's good and one, Nick.
Hey, that's good concentration, taking the ball hard to the hoop, knowing that someone's going to have you. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
A great trap initiated by the defense. Willis receives the pass. They work the perimeter. He needs to watch himself right now, Dick. Another foul could be a real difference maker.
As a coach, you always stress to your players that defending without fouling is most important. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Stolen. Davis is down emotionally right now, Dick.
Someone may have to talk to him. He needs to get back on track.
He goes up with it, scores it. Takes the jumper, nails the jumper. Down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. On the dribble, gives it up. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Missed the jumper.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
Adam, momentary look from three-point land. Number 32 with the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Chance to get an easy one here. Rims out. Cash it in. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Gave it up. Bad decision there by the senior. They'll work it around the arc. Jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Davis receives the ball.
Look at that spacing.
Looks at the three. The missed shot. the shooting guard, with the ball.
Excellent jump shot right there.
We're at the 7-minute mark. The small forward takes the feed. For two. No good. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Goes in. The Flyers are going to have to make some modifications here, Dick. They're going to have to throw out the idea of playing in the half court and get this into more of an up-tempo game.
Playing in the full court usually isn't their thing, but they're going to have to play in this manner in order to get back into the game.
Out on the wing. We're at the 6-minute mark. Number 32 gets the ball. Busts the jumper. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
Pollard handles the pass. Fed the low block. For two with a layup. On the outside. Goes up for two with a layup. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
I think when you have balance, inside, outside scoring, tempo control, where you control the pace of the game, and that's what they try to do with their balance. They'll go fast, they'll go slow. They try to dictate tempo. Up and inside.
Number 24, he cashed in on the layup and gets the foul.
He knew he was going to get fouled, Brad, but he took the hit like a man.
They will line him up. Wide, short, long, doesn't matter, doesn't go.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Two with a lay-in. Jay. He nails the bucket. The Flyers did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Certain offenses require that the ball goes through the high post. This will usually open up things on the wings and a low block, Brad. They did a great job of using the high post on that play.
The layup is good. Looking for a good shot. Here's the three ball. Scorches the net with a J. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it'll come down to in this game.
Tries for two. Was that beautiful or what? It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
They've been awesome, Brad. Every player who has stepped onto the court has been focused and has been looking to get his team involved. You've got to love this kind of teamwork.
work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Rims out. Seconds. He puts up the three ball. Gets the J to fall. On the outside. For two. Nice shot. We're at the 2 minute mark. And now the fadeaway jumper.
I'll tell you, you gotta be exceptional to make that shot. Because a lot of coaches don't like it because you're going away, you're not in rebound position. You better make it count.
The center with the ball. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. They push it up on the break. He drains it. And we're back to a two-point game. On the inside. Great shot! It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. And come up short. On the dribble, gives it up. That goes out of bounds, and we'll stay at this end. Let's take another look at this dunk.
That's a strong take. A strong, strong take to the goal.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, didn't they? The offense sets up from the sideline. Shot clock is dead. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. So they'll inbound on the near sideline. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
Dick, how's it feel to be over there calling those shots?
Everybody likes to call the shots, but the biggest thing for me is being equipped to call the shots. And that comes with preparation. You evaluate your team and you study your opponents. From there, you'll be able to be in a better position to make the right call.
Let's get back out on the floor. He tries the jumper. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. And the clock stops with a foul.
like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
He makes the second shot.
It's a two-possession game if they can score here.
Are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Williams commits his last personal. An easy one.
That's on the nylon, NBA.
Gets his second.
They need points on this possession, baby. It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
The lead is 5. What happens now, Dick?
Well, this is where momentum can swing in your favor or go against you enough to blow your game.
Working around the perimeter. Let's it fly. No good. Well, before we go any further, let's see who came in as our players of the game today.
Only one will walk away with the win, but both these kids gave it everything they had, and it was great to watch them compete.